Hindustan Shipyard Limited, strategically located at Visakhapatnam on the east coast of the Indian Peninsula, is the nation's premier shipbuilding organization, catering to the needs of shipbuilding, ship repairs and submarines. HSL is celebrating its 80th glorious year on 21st June 2021. Since the last 8 decades, HSL has been in the forefront of the Indian shipbuilding industry, thereby contributing to the nation's overall industrial development in the region. History was made in 1941 when Seth Walchand Hirachand Doshi, chairman of the famous Sindhia Company, decided to set up a shipyard in Visakhapatnam, now known as Hindustan Shipyard Limited. Seth Walchand Hirachand Doshi was the chairman of Sindhia Shipyard from 1940 to 1950. The synergy of man and machine in this niche and unique industry, graphically illustrated with a blend of color and hues, the commitment of the management and the dedicated service of the employees in pursuance of the lofty ideals of the founder. All these and more this treatise seeks to present in its portrayal of HSL's 80-year voyage and its vision for the future. All the employees of Hindustan Shipyard Limited recall with gratitude the untiring efforts of the past chairman and managing directors, who have put in their best years and efforts intending the growth of HSL from a small beginning to a multidisciplinary center of excellence today. With a rich and varied experience of over 3 decades in the Indian Navy, especially having the unique experience of overseeing construction of naval tankers in a foreign shipyard, the present chairman is steering the course of HSL in the right direction for the largest order ever for HSL, which is construction of fleet tankers for the Indian Navy. At 80th anniversary, HSL stands tall with 3 independent business units for shipbuilding, ship repairs and submarines, with exclusive facilities and specialized infrastructure. The government knows that HSL is strategically located at the mouth of the channel of Visakhapatnam Harbour. This channel forms the passage for a wide variety of naval and commercial vessels and leads into the nation's strategic and commercial units, and HSL stands guard to all these assets. Now, I will take you through the journey of the shipyard since its inception. Foundation stone for the modern shipyard at Visakhapatnam was laid in the thick of the freedom struggle in June 1941 by Indian National Congress President Dr. Babu Rajendra Prasad and named it Sindhia Shipyard. The city of destiny, as Vizag came to be called, was put prominently on the national map. Construction of shipyard commenced in 1942. However, noticeable progress could be made only after the cessation of Second World War. Jal Usha, construction of first ship, commenced in 1945. Indian shipping industry turned over a new leaf with the keel laying, a traditional milestone for commencement of ship construction, undertaken for the first 2 vessels in 1946. Both steamships were designed in UK. Keel for the third vessel, Kutub Tari, for the Sindhia Steam Navigation Company Limited, was laid in 1947. The first vessel in independent India, Jal Usha, was launched on 14th March 1948 by the first Prime Minister of India, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. Launching of Jal Usha was another landmark in the history of Indian shipping and shipbuilding. The second ship, Jal Prabha, was launched in 1948 by the Deputy Prime Minister, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. This launching was done from Delhi by a special communication arrangement. 3 ships constructed by the shipyard were delivered to the Sindhia Steam Navigation Company in 1949. Shipyard delivered its 5th vessel, Jal Pankhi, to the Sindhia Steam Navigation Company in 1950. Shipyard made history of delivering 3 vessels in consecutive years. A new chapter began with the Government of India taking over the Sindhia Shipyard by acquiring 2/3 share capital from Sindhias and registered as Hindustan Shipyard Limited on 21st January 1952. In 1953, a 125-ton crane, the only one of its kind at that time, was installed at Jetty. HSL delivered two vessels in 1954 and 1955 to Bharat Line and Sindhia Steam Navigation Company. The yard continued its winning streak of delivery of three vessels in consecutive years in 1956 and 1957. For honing the skills of the employees, a training school was started in 1957, which was instrumental in imparting systematic training to employees at all levels. Continuing with the trend of delivering vessels in time, HSL delivered two vessels to the Sindhia Steam Navigation Company in 1958. This fast pace of construction enabled HSL to cross the landmark of 1 lakh gross registered tonnage with construction of Jalveera in 1958. In 1959, INS Dhruvak, a mooring vessel, was built for the first time for Indian Navy by HSL. This was one of the three vessels delivered that year. In 1960, HSL delivered Jayalakshmi to New Dholera Steamships Company. Maintaining an increasing trajectory as far as deliveries of vessels are concerned, HSL hit another milestone of delivering four vessels in a year. An unique evolution, the first of its type, launching the vessel Vishwaprem in night, has been undertaken in December 1961. In July 1961, Government of India acquired all the shares from the Sindhias and thus Hindustan Shipyard Limited emerged as a fully owned Government of India undertaking. HSL won a Presidential Award and a Certificate of Honor in 1961-62 for its performance during the year in 1961. In 1962, the yard delivered two vessels to the Shipping Corporation of India. The yard crossed another landmark of processing of 1,000 ton steel at Hulshop for the first time in June 1962. In 1963, the yard delivered three vessels to the Shipping Corporation of India. Srimati Indira Gandhi, the then Union Minister of Broadcasting, launched HSL's 41st vessel, Jal Kendra, on 16th April 1964. In December 1964, HSL delivered two vessels and set foot into a new area of constructing a hydrographic survey vessel, INS Darshak, equipped with electronic devices and with diesel-electric propulsion. Apart from delivery of State of Madhya Pradesh to Shipping Corporation of India, a launch named Rohini was also constructed for ferrying our employees. The event of launching of first ship, Jal Usha, was immortalized on 5th April 1965 by releasing a special postage stamp depicting Jal Usha with the shipyard in the background. In 1966, the yard delivered four vessels to their owners. With a vision to expand the capacity of shipbuilding, the foundation stone of the graving dock was laid by Sri Morarji Desai, Deputy Prime Minister of India, in 1967. Sri K. Brahmanand Reddy, Honorable Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, launched the 49th vessel built in 1968. The yard again repeated its winning goal of delivery of three vessels in consecutive years in 1969 and 1970. Vessel Vishwadharma was fitted out in a record time of 6 months. The country's largest dry dock was inaugurated in 1971 by the then Minister of Shipping and Transport, Sri Raj Bahadur. In 1971, the yard delivered three vessels to their owners. An unforgettable and memorable occasion when training ship Rajendra was handed over to the owners in 1972 in the presence of Srimati Indira Gandhi, the then Prime Minister of India. In 1973, the yard delivered four vessels to their owners. The yard continued delivery of ship every year to their owners. The wet basin was commissioned in 1976. Thus, the yard became fully equipped for underwater and afloat repairs simultaneously. In 1977, the yard delivered 2 vessels to their owners. In 1978, the yard delivered 2 vessels to Indian Steamship Company. Out of 135 PSUs, only 34 made profits, and HSL made a net profit of 3.63 crores during the financial year 1977-78 and paid dividend. In 1979, the yard delivered 2 vessels to the Sindhia Steam Navigation Company. It delivered its 79th vessel, Jal Gopal, to the Sindhia Steam Navigation Company in 1980. As a mark of respect and remembrance to the father of the nation, the statue of Mahatma Gandhi was erected in the center of the yard. In 1982, Sri Virendra Patil, Union Minister of Shipping and Transport, approved the plan for construction of largest covered building dock in the country. The foundation stone was laid by Sri K. Vijay Bhaskar Reddy, the then Union Minister of Shipping and Transport, for the covered building dock in 1983. In 1984, the yard again delivered 2 vessels to their owners. A life-size statue of Seth Walchand Hirachand, installed at Sindhia Junction by Sri N.S.N. Reddy, Mayor of Visakhapatnam, in 1984. In continuation for the quest for diversification, HSL ventured into the oil platforms business. An offshore platform yard was constructed and inaugurated by Sri Gyani Zail Singh, the then President of India, in 1985. In 1986, the yard delivered 4 vessels to their owners. Old administrative block was refurbished and given a modern look in 1986. In less than 4 years, the largest covered building dock in India was constructed and inaugurated by Sri Gyani Zail Singh, the then President of India, in April 1987. By delivering its 93rd vessel, Lok Rajeshwari, to the Shipping Corporation of India in 1988, the yard crossed the landmark of 1 million deadweight tonnage. The yard delivered its 100th vessel, Lok Prakash, to the Shipping Corporation of India in 1989. The offshore yard exclusively created for construction of wellhead platforms for ONGC, and the yard served the most important regions of the nation where oil and gas are being explored and produced by ONGC. In 1990, the yard delivered 2 vessels in which INS Savitri, the first of the series of 4 offshore petrol vessels, is built for the Indian Navy. The yard delivered 5 vessels to Indian Navy in 3 years. For Krishna Godavari Basin, HSL fabricated 2 oil platforms, RV-10 and RV-17. And for the first time from Krishna Godavari Basin, oil was extracted through these oil platforms. In 1995, the yard delivered its 108th vessel, Ambika, a HSD oiler, to Indian Navy. In 1996, HSL became the first shipyard in the country to be awarded ISO 9001 certificate from LRQA, London. The first biggest passenger vessel, MV Swaraj Deep, was launched from Slipway in 1996. Hindustan Shipyard entered into a new area of submarine repairs of conventional type in a big way by bagging the order for major repair of INS Vagli, a Foxtrot class submarine of Indian Navy. In 1998, the yard delivered its 111th vessel, Goa, to the Shipping Corporation of India. The first biggest 1200 passenger vessel, Swaraj Deep, was delivered to Andaman and Nicobar Administration in 1999. Yard delivered 3 vessels in year 2000, which includes 2 50-ton bollard pull tugs to VPT and a 42,000-ton bulk carrier to Shipping Corporation of India. Rangat, a 100-passenger vessel for Andaman and Nicobar Administration, was delivered in 2001. In 2002, the yard delivered 3 vessels, a 25-ton bollard pull tug to Indian Navy, a 50-ton bollard pull tug to NMPT and 100-passenger vessel to Andaman and Nicobar Administration. In 2003, the yard delivered 3 vessels to their owners. Shipyard delivered 4 vessels in 2004, which includes 3 passenger vessels to Andaman and Nicobar Administration and a floating crane. In 2005, the yard delivered 11 vessels of different types, which includes barges, launch, dredger, tug and 100 passenger vessel. A removable partition was constructed, an innovative approach which has not been done anywhere else in the building dock to optimally utilize the docking space and to avoid floating of submarine under refit at the time of docking or undocking of other vessels in the building dock. Keel for the first bulk carrier was laid by Dr. Y.S. Rajshekhar Reddy, the then Honorable Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh in 2005. HSL secured prestigious order from ONGC for major layup repairs of jack-up rigs Sagar Pragati at Rs. 92 crores. This was the first high-tech, high-value order for ship repairs. INS Vagli, a Foxtrot-class submarine of Indian Navy, successfully completed its check dive at 40 meters depth and was handed over in 2006. This submarine participated in the President's Fleet Review held off Vishakhapatnam on 12th February 2006. In 2007, the yard delivered first of the 4 30,000-ton bulk carrier to GML Chennai. During 2008, HSL delivered 5 ships, 2 of which were 30,000-ton bulk carriers, 2 were 150 passenger vessels, and 1 700 passenger cum cargo vessel. In another first in India, a very large 30,000-ton bulker, MV Good Pilgrims, was launched from slipway at HSL. In the year 2009, HSL delivered oil recovery and pollution control vessel, a bulker and a tug. First of the 5 inshore patrol vessel of Indian Coast Guard was launched in 2009. The Cabinet took a decision in December 2009 to transfer the administrative control of HSL from Ministry of Shipping to Ministry of Defence. The presidential order was issued on 22nd February 2010. The first 53,000-ton bulker, Good Pride, delivered to GML in 2010 in the presence of M.M. Pallam Raju, Honorable Minister of State for Defence. During the year 2011 and 2012, HSL delivered 5 ships of different types, including 53,000-tonnage bulk carrier, IPV and tug. First high-value repair order for major repairs of jack-up rig Sagar Ratna of ONGC, completed and handed over in 2012. During the year 2013 and 2014, HSL delivered 5 ships of different types, including 53,000-ton bulk carrier, IPV and tug. First time in India, medium repairs cum modernization of an EKM submarine of Indian Navy was completed in 2015. The prestigious project of national importance was launched in 2016. This is the largest vessel with special features and first of its kind, which was indigenously designed and built by HSL. Yard delivered 5 vessels in 2016, which are 1 IPV and 4 tugs. HSL installed 3 megawatt rooftop solar power system in 2018. This is the largest rooftop solar plant in Andhra Pradesh installed at a single location. Launching of 6 vessels carried out simultaneously at covered building dock in 2018. HSL delivered 2 vessels in 2018 to Indian Navy and Deen Dayal Port Trust. In 2019, completed repairs on a naval vessel, INS Astradharini, ahead of its schedule. The yard delivered 10 vessels in 2019 and keel laid for 3 prestigious projects. In 2020, the yard completed normal refit of INS Sindhuvir ahead of schedule. Hindustan Shipyard delivered the prestigious ship of national importance in 2020, christened as Dhruv. Collaborator contract for design, supply of key machinery equipment, technical assistance for construction of 5 fleet support ships at HSL has been signed with Anadolu Shipyard, Turkey in 2020. Offshore oil rig Aban 2 and Shanti Sagar repairs have been completed in time the yard has signed a memorandum of understanding with Goa Shipyard on 5th Feb 2021 during Aero India 2021 at Bengaluru for business relation. MOU signed with Shipping Corporation of India for repair of SCI ships. HSL won semi-submersible pontoon contract on competitive tender process and contract of Rs. 495 crores was signed with Indian Navy in February 2021. In pursuance of export orders, HSL aggressively scouted the export market and repairs of lay vessel North Ocean 105 of USA was undertaken and refit completed within time schedule in April 2021. It is our pride that we employees of HSL serve the nation through service to HSL by building and repairing ships as well as submarines for nation's growth. Change is the only permanent and yard continues to grow in strength by adapting modern day technology with a commitment to reform with intent, perform with integrity and transform with intensity. Jai Hind!